Hey everyone, Forge Wolfgaming here to play Just Cause 4. Alright, I just wanted to clear this area. We gain the weapon I currently have, and now the sky. The agency distress beacon.
There we go.
Whew.
Locate one on target. Command advice.
Command here. Find that hostile.
Dun 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 dun. Speed up. Ooh, almost 400. Give a little flood boost. Grab there, boost. Up a bit. Here we go. Fine, if you take a gander, ball falls from right about there and such. Okay.
This is a grand ruin, my friend. Otorongo had three children, so you will find three Uma here, one commemorating each of them.
See?
The Espinosa mythos tells us that Otorongo's oldest child was a violent maniac. Standards for such things were different then. But I'm inclined to believe if the Espinosa's taught it. The opposite must be true.
Yeah. No, no, you don't.
That's one.
Okay, so this one's hooked up to three separate ones, but I have to wait until all three are done or to get to the damn thing. Alright. Yeet. There it is.
The youngest son of Otorongo was thought to be very sickly and ill, a result of frequent beatings. Beatings were common in those days. But why would a king waste an heir? It is nonsense.
You have a soothing voice, Avihuerta. That's two.
All right, the other one should be on the other side. Right there. And I'm just finding the lever for this one. There.
Yeah.
That they were buried together suggests that Otorongo's offspring were not yet considered adults by the society at large. This may mean that the Espinosas murdered children to prevent the line from continuing.
Last one. Vault's open. Let you know what I find.
See, please do.
Waiting the green faces of my forebears.
Such a message on the tomb of one's own children.
Hmm.
We are making some progress, but I don't yet understand the significance. Por favor, Rico, you must help me find more verses.
I will. Neat.
Such machinery and so old a civilization. Truly remarkable.
All right.
Tom Sheldon. Well, I guess you got my message. It's all clear, Mita.
I'm on my way.
Who's that? Why are you here, Sheldon?
When you went dark after Medici, I figured I'd look through some of your old files, see where you might end up. Turns out your dad was working with Oscar Espinosa back in the day. Something called Project Iapa.
What do you know about Iapa?
I know there's lots of buzz about Solis at the agency these days. Talk of weather modification technology, strategic atmospherics. Of course, once the higher-ups heard that I was looking at those Iapa files, I ended up on administrative leave.
Guess I'm not the only one who doesn't trust Tom Sheldon.
I know you're looking to take out Iapa, Rico. I've already done some of the legwork.
You screwed me over more than once at Medici. I don't want your help, Sheldon.
Well, you're gonna need it. I did some snooping around Zona Dos. Turns out that place is constantly surrounded by a nasty lightning storm. Fried poor Annabelle here. It seems pretty suspicious to have a standing lightning storm like that, don't you think?
This a friend of yours, Rico?
Not exactly. Mira Morales, this is Tom Sheldon. Known him for 20 years. He cannot be trusted.
Buenas.
Don't listen to this guy, senorita. Pleased to meet you. Rico and I were just discussing the situation with Zona Dos.
And you know how to access the core?
I don't know anything about the core, but I got a good idea how to get us past that lightning storm.
We'll look with Annabelle, Sheldon. We'll figure something else out.
He's got a plan, Rico. And we don't.
Okay. Now there's a river that runs underneath the facility. I figure we use a boat to get close. You remember the Stingray base back in Medici? The same basic concept.
Do you want to make a lightning-proof boat?
Yeah, bingo. Now, I also hear there's a nearby research lab that's testing a way to harness lightning. Figure we find something there to protect the boat, spare us poor Annabelle's fate.
You're talking about that facility in the mountains, Meriolo.
You got it.
And we could do the custom boat work at Prospero Astiero.
Interesting.
Yeah. Coming around, aren't you?
Why are you doing this, Sheldon?
Well, because I owe you, Rico. You want to take out Iapa, I want to help you do it. Besides, we both know we can't have just anybody running around with a weather weapon, for God's sakes.
Not a better idea?
Shit. That's what I like to hear.
So, we meet up at Meteor Lab when we're ready?
Sounds good. You know, for a minute there, I thought you were gonna shoot me.
Not this time, Sheldon.
There, and let's see. So I gotta do this one, which requires me going all the way up there. But I got two more to do down here. Okay.
Looking for a ride nearby. Why don't you grab the car they're expecting and pick them up?
Oh no!
Bien. Time to pick up your client.
This is car 04. Client is in the vehicle.
Bunny, now just destroy that vehicle, but it's gotta look like an accident. They can't know that we know. You know?
Okay.
Took you long enough. If I'm late for my meeting, you'll be the one that hears about it.
Dropped off your client, Santo.
Qué bien, Rico. They were up to no good.
Huh. All right. All right, that's going to be it for this one. Thanks for watching and see you all next time. Bye.